stupendous stranger. Prophets, shepherds, kings, advise. Lead me to my master's manger. Show me where my saviour lies. O most mighty, O most holy, far beyond the seraph's fall, are you then so mean and lowly, as unheeded prophets call?
O the magnitude of meekness, worth from worth immortal sprung, O the strength of infant weakness, if eternal is so young. God all bounteous, all creative, whom our sins could not dissuade, you have come to be a native of the very world you made.
The glory of little Bethlehem is foretold.
Much from you, Bethlehem, in Ephrata, small as you are among Judah's clans, from you will come a king for me over Israel, one whose origins are far back in the past, in ancient times. He will rise up to lead them in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. They will enjoy security, for then his greatness will reach to the ends of the earth, and there will be peace.
Still we see. the angel Gabriel salutes the Virgin Mary. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, with a message for a girl betrothed to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The girl's name was Mary. The angel went in and said to her, "Greetings, most favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was deeply troubled by what he had said and wondered what this greeting could mean. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for God has been gracious to you. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. The Lord will give him the throne of his ancestor David, and he will be king over Israel forever. His reign shall never end." "How can this be?" said Mary. "I know not a man," the angel answered. "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you." "I'm the Lord's servant," said Mary. "May it be as you have said." Then the angel left her.
One day while Mary knelt in prayer, she saw an angel standing there. His glory filled the dwelling place. He said to her, "Hail, full of grace." Now Mary feared and bowed her head. "Oh, do not hear," the angel said, "for God shall send his son to thee. His holy mother thou shalt be." Then Mary spoke the blessed word, "Behold the handmaid of the Lord. As thou hast said, so be it done." The Son of God became her son.
Everyone made his way to his own town to be registered. Joseph went up to Judea from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to register in the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was a descendant of David. And with him went Mary, his betrothed, who was expecting her child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her baby, and she gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them at the inn.
Love came down at Christmas. Love all lovely, love divine. Love was born at Christmas, star and angels gave the sign. Worship we the Godhead, love incarnate, love divine. Worship we our Jesus, but wherewith the sacred sign? Love shall be our token, love shall be yours and love be mine. Love to God and to all men, love the plea and gift and sign.
Peace to all in whom he delights. After the angels had left them and
and return to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Come, let us go straight to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." They hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. When they saw the child, they related what they had been told about him, and all who heard were astonished at what the shepherds said. Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart.
Yet Mary the mother responded at him and softly touched the manger's robe. Joseph sat musing on a bundle of hay. Shepherds praised sweetly a small half hay.
The angels stood smiling in heaven's joy and humbly adoring the infant Christ boy. The ox and the donkey forgot the first straw and knelt down in wonder at what they saw.
The walls were shining like molten gold, the wind sang gaily around the fold, and gleaming silver strewed every star, and sang a star greeted from heaven afar.
Jesus was born at Bethlehem in Judea during the reign of Herod. After his birth, wise men from the east arrived in Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We observe the rising of his star, and we have come to worship him." King Herod was troubled when he heard this, and so was the whole of Jerusalem. We called together the priests, chief priests, and the scribes of the Jews, and asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "At Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet wrote: Bethlehem in the land of Judah, you are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you shall come a ruler to be the shepherd of my people Israel."
Then Herod summoned the wise men secretly and asked them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word that I may go myself and worship him." After hearing what the king had to say, they set out. And there before them was the star they had seen rising, and it went ahead of them until it stopped above the place where the child lived. They were overjoyed at the sight of it, and entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and bowed low before him. They opened their treasure chests and presented gifts to him, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then they returned to their own country by another route. They had been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod.
It might have been just someone else's story. Some chosen people get a special king. We leave them to their own peculiar glory. We don't belong. It doesn't mean a thing. But when these three arrive, they bring us with them, Gentiles like us. Their wisdom might be ours. A steady step that finds an inner rhythm, a pilgrim's eye that sees beyond the stars.
They did not know his name, but still they sought him. They came from elsewhere, but still they found. In temples, they found those he sold and bought him, but in the filthy stable, hallowed ground, their courage gives our questing hearts a voice to seek, to find, to worship, to rejoice.
Sing. Let us pray as we remember the story of Christmas. On that holy night, he came to us as a child, cradled in a borrowed bed of straw, as there was no room in the inn. Open our hearts to the needs of the homeless and the hungry. On that holy night, your living word leapt down, casting light on all who are in darkness. Give strength and peace to all who suffer. On that holy night, the angels proclaimed peace on earth. Strengthen all who work for peace and justice.
On that holy night, shepherds heard your good news. Give us grace to spread your good news of joy and unite us in one family, that we may shine with the one light that scatters all our darkness. On that holy night, heaven and earth came together, and in your child you gave us power to be your children. May we be faithful and live your light. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Ooh, 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 ooh. snow.